Welcome to the Windom Quilted Bomber Jacket Sew Along. You're gonna love this jacket. It is the perfect blend of cozy winter comfort and chic style. I love it so much. Let's jump right in to the pattern specifics. This jacket has a lot going on. It has those classic raglan sleeves for a bomber jacket, front zip, welt zipper pockets, chunky ribbed bands, and a lining, plus some easy quilting for added texture and warmth. The pattern includes 10 pattern pieces. You're gonna need them all. Don't be intimidated by that. The sizing runs 0 to 34, and this pattern actually has a good bit of ease built in. It's kind of your typical amount of ease for outerwear to make sure that you can layer garments underneath it, but just know that going in as you're selecting your size. Let's talk fabric recommendations. This jacket is super cool because it's a bomber jacket, typically made in knit, but this one is actually designed for wovens, and you can use any kind of woven here. We've made the sample for the magazine and the sample today in this lovely flannel from Riley Blake. And as if this flannel wasn't cozy enough, we're actually gonna quilt it, and it's gonna be super cozy and soft and perfect for those cooler months. But I actually wanna make this jacket in linen for spring and maybe bulk up the layers a little bit for those deep winter days. You can really do so much with this jacket. It's really kind of an all-season pattern, and that's why I love it. The other great thing is that you actually don't need that much yardage. Depending on the width of fabric that you're working with and the size that you're making, you'll need about 1.5 to 2 1/8 yards for the exterior fabric and the lining fabric. That's not very much. You'll also need a little bit of knit fabric. If you want to get that classic bomber look, you want to pick a nice sturdy ribbed knit, you only need 1/2 yard of that. You'll need 3 zippers, 1 16-inch separating zipper, and 2 6-inch all-purpose zippers for those pockets. You'll need a teeny tiny bit of interfacing to get those welt pockets nice and neat, and some bias binding if you're going to do the optional Hong Kong seam finish, which is really pretty, makes those insides nice and neat. Today, as I mentioned, I'm sewing with this beautiful patterned flannel from Riley Blake. It's their woolen flannel line, and it's very similar to the fabric that we use for the finished sample. It's warm and cozy. It's got this really nice light pattern on it that looks so rich when it is quilted up. It's also super easy to work with, and I'm gonna be lining it with a solid flannel. And it's pretty awesome because those two layers actually kind of stick together, and it makes the quilting process really easy. So if you're intimidated about that, flannel's a great pick. Quick note about this sew along. There is so much going on in this jacket. There are so many features, so many details that make it special. And we are gonna really lean heavily on the instructions and the great how-to illustrations provided by the designer, Kimberly Payne. And we're gonna touch on the harder parts of the construction in the sew along today and really walk you through those just in case anything is intimidating. So we'll talk quilting, we'll go through those welt pockets really slowly, we will install the rib knit and the front zipper, and we'll just walk you through all the hard parts so you can really approach this jacket and put it together with confidence. Before we jump into construction, you'll need to print and tile your pattern, and then we're gonna jump right into the quilting in the next lesson. Let's get started.